Hi everyone, and welcome to this grade 11 mathematics lesson where we will be exploring the introduction to vectors. My name is Ms. Donnell Phillips. Let's get started. Before we actually start exploring what vectors are, what exactly are scalars? Because sometimes vectors and scalars come hand in hand. A scalar is said to have magnitude but no direction. So distance, speed, time, temperature, mass, length, area, volume, density, charge, pressure, energy, work, and power are all scalar quantities. So as long as we have some mathematical quantity that just has magnitude but no direction, then that is considered to be a scalar quantity. Vectors, on the other hand, is an object that has both a magnitude and a direction. Geometrically, we can picture a vector as a directed line segment whose length is the magnitude of the vector with an arrow indicating the direction. The direction of the vector is from tail to its head. So we can use an arrow to represent a vector. The length of the arrow would determine the magnitude of the vector, and the direction of the arrow would symbolize the direction of the vector. So while scalars only have magnitude, vectors have magnitude and direction. So if I say that something is 5 meters long, then that is an example of a scalar quantity. But if I say that something is 5 meters east, then that is an example of a vector quantity. Vector notation. We could represent vectors mathematically or graphically. For the mathematical representation, we denote vectors using boldface, as in A or B. You could see that it's bold there. Especially when writing them by hand, where one cannot easily write a boldface, people will sometimes denote vectors using arrows as A with a small arrow over it or B with a small arrow. So when we're representing vectors, we could either use bold letters or we could use letters with small arrows over them. The magnitude of a vector is shown by 2 vertical bars on either side of the vector. So we have a vertical bar A, vertical bar, or it can be written with double vertical bars so as to not confuse it with absolute value. So as long as you see a bold letter with 2 bars on either end, that represents the magnitude of a vector. Graphical representation. Vectors are drawn as arrows. An arrow has both a magnitude, that is how long it is, and a direction, that is the direction which it points in. The starting point of a vector is known as its tail, and the end point is known as its head. So we have some examples of some vectors here. We have arrows going in all directions. These are all examples of vectors. Directions. There are many acceptable methods of writing vectors. As long as the vector has a magnitude and a direction, it is most likely acceptable. Relative directions. The simplest method of expressing direction is with relative direction. We could say to the left, to the right, forward, backward, up, down, etc. But if we're using a compass direction, we have to say things like north, south, east, west. If a vector does not point exactly in one of the compass directions, then we use an angle. For example, we can have a vector pointing 40 degrees north of west. The direction of this vector can also be described as west 40 degrees north, but we would write W 40 degrees N. Or we could also say N 50 degrees W, which is north 50 degrees west. Types of vectors. The zero vector. A zero vector is a vector when the magnitude of the vector is zero and the starting point of the vector coincides with the terminal point. In other words, for a vector AB, the coordinates of the point A are the same as that of the point B. Then the vector is said to be a zero vector and it is denoted by zero. This follows that the magnitude of the zero vector is also zero and the direction of such a vector is indeterminate. So a zero vector is just a vector that has a magnitude of zero and the direction is indeterminate. A unit vector. A unit vector is a vector which has a magnitude of 1. So zero vectors have vectors that have magnitudes of 0, and unit vectors have vectors that have magnitude of 1. Position vectors. If 0 is taken as reference origin and A is an arbitrary point in space, then the vector OA is called the position vector of the point. Position vectors are simply vectors that start from the origin. So any vector that starts from the origin is considered a position vector. Equal vectors. Equal vectors are vectors that have the same magnitude and the same direction. Equal vectors may start at different positions. So here we have some examples of some equal vectors. If we look at them clearly, we can see that all of them are equal vectors except vector AB, because that one is going in the opposite direction. Negative vectors. If two vectors are the same in magnitude, but exactly opposite in direction, then both the vectors are negative of each other. Assume there are two vectors A and B, such that these vectors are exactly the same in magnitude, but opposite in direction. Then these vectors can be given as A is equal to minus B. And if we look here, we could see that vector A and vector B have the same length, but they're going in opposite direction. So this is an example of negative vector. Operations on vectors. Addition of vectors. Given two vectors A and B, we form their sum, A plus B, as follows. We translate the vector B until it still coincides with the head of A. Recall, such translation does not change a vector. Then, the directed line segment from the tail of A to the head of B is the vector A plus B. So we have this little diagram that represents the addition of vector A and B. We could see vector A represented with the blue arrow and vector B represented with the red arrow. So if we were to add the two vectors, we would have to take the second vector and join it to the head of the first vector. And the resultant vector would be the sum of the two vectors. Subtraction of vectors. We define subtraction as addition with the opposite of a vector. Example, B subtract A is equal to B plus negative A. This is equivalent to turning vector A around in the applying the above rules for addition. Can you see how the vector X in the below figure is equal to B minus A? Notice how this is the same as stating that A plus X is equal to B, just like with subtraction of scalar numbers. So when we're subtracting vectors, we're pretty much just reversing the addition. So now we're going to work a few examples where you would see how we add and subtract vectors algebraically and graphically. So let's say we have to add vector A, which is 3 minus 1, and vector B, which is 2, 3. The first thing we have to do is take note of the x components and the y components of the vector. So vector A plus vector B. All we're doing is adding the x's and then we're adding the y's. So the x in vector A, we have 3. The x in vector B is 2. Then we're going to add the y's. The y in vector A is minus 1. And the y in vector B is 3. When we add them, we have 3 plus 2, 5. And minus 1 plus 3, 2. So when we add vector A and vector B, we get 5, 2. And this is how we add vectors algebraically. When we're subtracting vectors, the same principle applies. We subtract the x's and then we subtract the y's. So let us now work another example. We're going to work the same ones. A being 3 and negative 1, and B being 2 and 3. If we wanted to subtract these two vectors, vector A subtract vector B, instead of adding the x components, we will now subtract them. So we would have 3 subtract 2, and then we would have minus 1 subtract 3. So 3 take 2 gives us 1, and minus 1 subtract 3 would give us minus 4. So when I take vector B from vector A, I get 1 minus 4. Now when we're adding or subtracting vectors using a graph, all we're doing is using arrows to represent the vectors, and we shift them around so that we're going to end up with some result on vector. But when we're adding or subtracting them algebraically, we focus on the x components by themselves, and then we focus on the y components by themselves. So now we're going to do two examples of adding and subtracting vectors using graphs. So in this example, we're going to add vector A, 6 minus 2, and vector B, minus 4, 4. But instead of adding them algebraically, we are going to be adding them on a graph so that you could actually see what's going on. But if we were to add them algebraically, we would have 6 plus minus 4 as x component and minus 2 plus 4 as the y component. And this would give us 6 plus minus 4 is 2, and minus 2 plus 4 is 2. So we know that the answer that we're supposed to get should be 2, 2. So let's look at it on a graph. Vector A, 6, negative 2, is represented with the blue arrow. So we count 6 on the x-axis and then we come down 2. So this is vector A. And vector B is minus 4, 4. But when we're adding vectors graphically, all we're doing is we're connecting the arrows from head to tail. So we have vector A here. We're going to just shift vector B and connect it to vector A, right? So when we shift it, you could still see that it's the same vector here. The important thing is the magnitude and the direction. And we could see that both of the vector B's have the same magnitude, they have the same length, and both of them are still pointing in the same direction. This is where the vector ends. When we add vector A to vector B, it ends here. If we were to read this point off of the graph, this is at 2, 2. And when we did a calculation, we see that the vector is actually 2, 2. So whenever we're adding vectors graphically, All we're doing is we're shifting the vector, shifting the arrows and connecting it to the other arrows. So vector A, 6 minus 2, and vector B, minus 4, 4. When we connect them together, they end at positive 2, 2. And we could see that is actually correct when we solved it algebraically. In this second example, we have vector A equals minus 4, 4, and vector B equals 2, 3. We want to subtract vector B from vector A. And we have represented this on this graph. So we could see vector A, minus 4, 4, and vector B, 2, 3. Now, I did explain earlier that whenever we're subtracting vectors, all we're doing is we're flipping the second one. So if you look at vector B, when we move it to be joined with vector A, instead of it going in the same direction that it's going in originally, it's flipped. It's now going in the opposite direction. It now becomes a negative vector. And indeed, if we look here, this is actually negative B, which is the negative vector, right? Instead of using 2, 3, because it became a negative vector, we're now using negative 2, negative 3. So algebraically, when we work it, putting the x components together and the y components together, we get negative 4 subtract 2, which is negative 6, and 4 subtract 3, which is just 1. It means that when we graph the subtraction of these two vectors, it should end at negative 6, 1. Now let's look at the graph. When we move vector B to join it with vector A, and we turn into the negative vector, it ends right here. And if we were to read off this point, we could see that it ends at negative 6, one. So we can actually add or subtract vectors algebraically, where we put the x components and the y components together, or we could draw them on graphs and shift the vectors around, and we would still end up with the same answer. So for your homework, you are going to classify the following quantities as scalars or vectors: 12 km, 1 meter south, 2 meters per second and 45 degrees, 0.75 degrees and 2 centimeters, 100 km per hour, and 0 degrees. You're going to also subtract vector K, which is 4, 5, from vector V, which is 12, 2, algebraically and graphically. And lastly, add the vectors A, which is 8, 13, and vector B, 26, 7, algebraically and graphically. So to summarize today's lesson, vectors have both magnitude and direction, while scalars only have magnitude. Vectors can be represented mathematically using boldface letters, or with small arrows over the letters, or we can represent them graphically using arrows. A zero vector is a vector when the magnitude of the vector is zero. A unit vector is a vector when the magnitude of the vector is one. A position vector starts at the origin. Equal vectors are vectors that have the same magnitude and the same direction. Negative vectors have the same magnitude but different direction. When we add or subtract vectors algebraically, we compute the x components together and then the y components together. I do hope that I was able to shed some light on this grade 11 mathematics lesson, Introduction to Vectors. My name is Ms. Donnell Phillips. See you next time.